Good day to Dinarans on the go and in the know, October 27th, 2019. No hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest. Trump approves special OPS raid targeting ISIS leader Aghdani. October 26, 1918 10:45 p.m. EDT World International Affairs Syria. The United States military has conducted a special operations raid targeting one of its most high-value targets, Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, the leader of the Islamic State militant group ISIS. Newsweek has learned, Donald Trump approved the mission nearly a week before it took place, amid reports Saturday of U.S. military helicopters over Syria northwestern Idlib province. A senior Pentagon official familiar with the operation and army official briefed on the matter told Newsweek that Baghdadi was the target of the top-secret operation in the last bastion of the country's Islamist-dominated opposition, a faction that has clashed with ISIS in recent years. A U.S. Army source briefed on the results of the operation told Newsweek that Baghdadi was killed in the raid, and the Defense Department told the White House they have high confidence that the high-value target killed was Baghdadi, but further verification is pending. Members of a team from the Joint Special Operations Command carried out Saturday high-level operation after receiving actionable intelligence, according to sources familiar with the operation. The location raided by special operations troops had been under surveillance for some time. On Saturday night, after the operation had concluded, President Trump tweeted, "Something very big has just happened. Baghdadi was dead pending verification," the Pentagon source told Newsweek. Next article of interest. Iraqi security sources, "We received confirmation from inside Syria that Baghdadi was killed." October 27, 2019 9:10. Two Iraqi security sources told Reuters they had received confirmation of the death of ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi from inside Syria. "Our sources from inside Syria confirmed to the Iraqi intelligence team in charge of chasing al-Baghdadi that he was killed along with his bodyguard in Idlib after discovering his hideout as he tried to move his family from Idlib towards the Turkish border," one of the sources told Reuters. This, according to U.S. media reports, killed Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi in a special operation carried out by U.S. forces in the Syrian province of Idlib. While the information has not been officially confirmed, the White House announced that U.S. President Donald Trump will make an important statement on foreign policy. For his part, Trump said in a tweet on his Twitter that something big has just happened without reveals any details. Next article of interest. Abdul Mahdi chooses 5 new ministers. These are to be changed. Baghdad, October 26, 2019 2043. 5 cabinet ministers will face change during a cabinet reshuffle planned by Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi, government spokesman Saad Al-Hadithi said. Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi has chosen replacements for 5 ministers who will be replaced as part of the announced reforms, Hadithi said in a televised interview. He added that the names will be submitted by Abdul Mahdi to the House of Representatives to vote on them. According to a senior source, the change will affect Communications Minister Naim Al-Rabai, Minister of Electricity Lawi Al-Kutlib, Minister of Immigration and Displaced Nawful Bahia, Industry Minister Saleh Al-Jubari and Minister of Sports and Youth Ahmed Riyad Al-Obaidi. Next article of interest. Demonstrators take control of Iranian consulate in Karbala. Saturday, October 26, 2019 11:17 p.m., the Iraqi demonstrators have managed to climb up onto the Iranian consulate roof in Karbala and hoist the Iraqi flag there. They also besieged the consulate, chanting slogans against Tehran and militias loyal to it. The Iranian regime has lost its power over the minds of the Shiite Iraqis. It finally happening. The death toll from protests this month has soared to 220, including dozens killed since Friday. The demonstrations first erupted on October 1, with protesters railing against government corruption and unemployment, while a second wave broke out late Thursday. The latest round of demonstrations has been notably violent, with 63 people killed and more than 2,000 wounded over just 2 days, according to the Iraqi Human Rights Commission. 3 protesters were killed in the capital Baghdad on Saturday, with medics and officials reporting trauma wounds sustained by tear gas canisters lobbed at demonstrators. Next article of interest. Parliament confirms continuing work, denying evacuation of its structures. Saturday, October 26, 2019, 7:20 p.m., the Media Department of Parliament in a statement said that some media and social networking sites circulated on Saturday news that the evacuation of the House of Representatives, adding that while the Media Department in the Parliament categorically denies such news, it affirms that the Council has functioned normally and that its staff left after the official working hours of the Council. He added, "We would like to point out that the work in the House of Representatives is continuing on Sunday normally and that is a normal time as usual for all employees of the Council." Next article of interest. The Minister of Labour announces the mechanism of distributing the emergency grant. 27th October, 2019. Minister of Labour and Social Affairs Bassem Abdelzaman announced on Sunday the launch of the first meal of emergency grantees. After registering more than 2 million unemployed people, I started launching the first meal of emergency grant beneficiaries in Baghdad and the governorates of the country, Abdelzaman said in a statement reported by the official daily Al Sabah. It will include 900,000 unemployed people as the first meal, he added. The distribution of the grant will be through the Exchange Centers for Iraq Gates, which deployed in Baghdad and the provinces of the country, which have been published addresses through the website of the ministry, indicating at the same time the willingness to open an emergency outlet in any area free of a subsidiary of the company, so that the beneficiaries can easily receive the grant. Abdelzaman disclosed that his ministry has started the procedures of distributing the emergency grant among beneficiaries by sending text messages to those covered by 100,000 people every 2 consecutive days, calling on his mobile phone to receive a text message to wait for sending another message containing the secret code of the grant. He explained, the grant covered the unemployed from different levels of education for both sexes, according to a mechanism prepared in coordination with the Office of Financial Supervision to ensure the transparency of the distribution of the grant among the eligible beneficiaries. Next article of interest. Karbala plans to distribute 50,000 plots of land and establish a special fund for the poor. 27th October, 2019. Karbala Governor Nassif Jassim Al-Khattabi announced on Sunday the distribution of more than 50,000 housing plots for the eligible groups. Al-Khattabi said in a statement reported by the official newspaper Morning and Saw It Information that the province has completed the mechanism and procedures for the distribution of residential plots among the eligible categories, has exceeded 50,000 pieces ready for distribution soon, and we also have more than 40,000 other pieces will be distributed once complete the screening and identification procedures. He added that the province suffers from the existence of some obstacles in the distribution mechanisms, including the lack of powers for the provinces to expand and update the basic design, which needs federal approvals, but added that this matter will be presented to the Council of Ministers to approve the granting of powers. If the approvals are issued, the governorate has more than 70,000 pieces ready for distribution, Khattabi said. All preparations have been made to sort and distribute residential plots among citizens, the poor and the employees of the districts alike, which have special laws. Khattabi revealed that the existence of a project is the first of its kind will be submitted to the provincial council in the absence of a clear and strong government program, noting that this project will depend on the distribution of local revenues among the needy poor and orphans within the social security. He explained that the project depends on opening a social security fund whose funds are from public revenues, fees and taxes, and we will proceed to impose fees and revenues on foreign visitors, because the visitor program dollars have not benefited from the province in years, and that the granting of funds to the poor continue until they receive salaries from the state, Al-Khattabi said. The main demands that the governorate needs are laws related to agrarian reform, because agriculture is one of the most important pillars of the economy, to self-sufficiency. Next article of interest. Khalidi, cabinet changes will not extinguish the flames of demonstrations. 27th October, 2019, MP Mohammed Al Khalidi, Sunday that the vents of all ministerial changes by Prime Minister Del Abdul Adi will not extinguish the flames of demonstrations, pointing out that calm depends on the iteration of the designation of the overment and come to a UN-dependent government and an end to the WADA system file in the outry. Khalidi said in a statement to the information that the ministerial changes made by the Prime Minister will not work, as it was better to implement the government program from the beginning in order to avoid the arrival of the situation to what it is now. He added that the situation in Iraq is very difficult, and the bloodshed during the demonstrations will not be resolved by administrative matters, but there will be a judiciary and courts to hold accountable those who are offenders and guilty of the people. He explained that the solution to the current problem lies in the change of government, and the arrival of non-partisan personalities, with away from quotas in all positions, noting that the replacement of the entire government is much better than making some changes in the joints. He pointed out that the amendment of the Constitution is very difficult, as the amendment must be approved by everyone from different components and in all provinces in accordance with Article 142 of the Constitution. Next article of interest. A source in the Prime Minister's office comments on reports that Abdul Mahdi intends to resign. October 27, 2019 10-3. A source in the office of Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi said on Sunday that Abdul Mahdi is continuing to carry out his duties and has no intention of resigning from his post. The source said in a press statement that Abdul Mahdi did not talk about the resignation, not even with those closest to him, and now he considers that he has the task of fulfilling the demands of the demonstrators and make ministerial amendments, and has no intention or even the idea to resign. Stressing that talk about the resignation of Abdul Mahdi shame about health, it is noteworthy that local and Arab media talked about the intention of Iraqi Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi to resign from his post. The Independent newspaper quoted sources as saying that Abdul Mahdi discussed last week his decision to resign with representatives of the parliamentary blocs, Sayran and Conquest, but he received a clear rejection of this step. Next article of interest. Iraq welcomes Baghdadi's death and confirms, "We await final investigations." 27 October, 2019, announced Iraq, Sunday, welcomed the killing of the leader of the Ash criminal Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi in Syria, as he emphasized that he is aiding for the final investigation on his body. Iraq welcomes the killing of terrorist Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi and he considers it a victory for all the countries of the world that have contributed to the war against terrorism, said O.Gen. Tahsin al-Khafiji, spokesman for the Joint Operations Command. Al-Khafiji added, "Joint operations are currently awaiting final reports on the scientific identification of al-Baghdadi arrest raw analysis and with SIS leaders, and on the existence of coordination or cooperation Iraqi-American in the process of killing al-Baghdadi." Al-Khafiji said, "Iraqi intelligence services have cooperated with America through joint operations from the beginning of operations until now, as well as cooperation with Russia, Iran and Syria through the Joint Intelligence Cooperation Center to know the location of Baghdadi and monitor its movements." More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.